What we're going to do in this video is to take a look at one of these three-phase circuit breaker boxes that we have here in the lab. The first thing that I'm going to do is to take the door off and to take the front panel off of the breaker box. There's a note here inside that says we need to shut off the main switch before we do that. So I want to respect that warning. Let's go ahead and turn off the main switch and then take the cover off. You'll notice that we still have some lights on, and we're using a battery-powered light behind me here so that we have some lighting here to make the video. Let's go ahead and take the door off and the main cover. What I really like about this particular breaker box is that it's been wired up in a very professional way. What I'll be discussing here is how power flows through all of these switches. Let's start up here at the top with the orange conduit and work our way through all of these breakers here. We have five lines that come in here from the conduit into the box. There's four black colored ones and another one that's striped green and yellow. We'll start with the one that's striped green and yellow. That's the earth ground, and we can see that it snakes around through the box and is bonded over here to the metal casing of the box itself. So that ensures that all of the box is at the earth level. There's a bus bar here over to the side of the box where this ground is distributed to all of the individual circuits. Let's now take a look at these other four black wires up here and see where they go. Three of them carry the three phases, and one of them is neutral. The three phases are attached here to the top of the switch. We have the red phase, the yellow phase, and the blue phase. We're following the old UK color code scheme here. The neutral line here is attached to a bus bar. On the other side of the main switch, we have the three phases exiting, and then they're wrapped around to the top side of this residual current circuit breaker. This is a safety device that monitors the power flow through the three phases and neutral and tries to detect earth faults, which would happen if somebody were being shocked. The other side of this safety device has the three phases, which then are attached to bus bars that go up here through the center of the breaker box and are hidden behind plastic casing here. The neutral wire is bonded over here to a neutral bar at the right side of the breaker. We can see up here at the top side of the neutral bar individual connections that are then fed or distributed throughout the lab here. The bus bars that are hidden behind this casing distribute the phases to all of these circuit breakers here. Line 1 gets the red phase, line 2 gets the yellow phase, and line 3 gets the blue phase. I can tell that those are the phases these circuit breakers get because over here on the left side I can see at the output of the switches that we have red, yellow, and blue lines connected up there. The same scheme is true over here on the right side of the breakers. These six breakers down here at the lower side of this bank are not used. What I really like about the design of this particular breaker box is that it's very safe. There's really nowhere that I could accidentally touch in this breaker box and get a shock. Now that we've seen how the power flows through this breaker box, let's put the panel back together, put the door back on, and turn the lights back on here in the lab. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.